Well, South Africa's Deputy Finance Minister Mcebisi Jonas says that the country is on a reform track and will achieve economic growth. Here are excerpts from his interview with CCTV's Sumitra Nydoo.
Treasury has been saying that there would be an assessment of all the SOEs, the ones that are not working, would be disposed of. How far are we?
That work is going on. We've just, presented the framework for private participation in the SOCs. And I think there's general positive acceptance of the framework that we've developed. And of course, we have to continue debating it and how we actually eventually implementing it. In some instances, I think you rationalization process of some of the state-owned enterprises is happening. It's happening faster in provinces, by the way, than in the national at the moment, because I think you also have similar problem where in provinces you have 6 or 9 agencies and so on and so on. They are beginning to rationalize them and closing some of them and shifting some of the functions into departments, etc. That work is happening. The governance also is. So our view is that you've got to go through a period of stabilizing some of these SOCs. I mean, bring back stability in them, strengthen governance, etc. Also strengthen the balance sheet a little bit so that you could then start looking for private participation in some of them. The framework existed, if you recall. I mean, there was a framework put on the table, it got shelved, and so on. So that is beginning to come back to the center of the discussion. There's a sector reform is critical. We need structural reforms in our economy. Part of it is looking at different sectors, the level and extent of competition, the level at which the playing field encourages private investment or doesn't, and so on and so on and so on.
Does that mean that there will be no more funding for SAA from government?
Our attitude at the moment is that most of the SOCs will be funded on either on the back of their balance sheet or through selling non-core assets in government. So we are not, if we are to finance them, it won't be in a manner that widens deficit.
How concerned are you about the political developments and its impact on the economy?
When politics are bad, economics suffer. I mean, it's a simple formula. When you have terrible politics, your economy suffer. So the need for stabilizing politics and ensuring that there is, because it also creates uncertainty, it feeds into uncertainty in the economy, and therefore it feeds into less confidence and creating less confidence in the economy. So from where we're sitting, we think it's important that we create a bit of certainty at the political level.